Thanks for joining me today. I'm Corel Painter Master Aaron Rutten, and in this video, I'll be demonstrating how to use Corel's Neon Lights Brush Pack. This brush pack is compatible with Corel Painter Essentials, and ParticleShop. So I have an image open here that we can work with. These are some people that are at a party, and right now the background is kind of boring, so let's spice that up by adding some neon lights. Let's locate the Neon Lights Brush Pack. We can look in our brush selector, and there's neon lights. Now, depending on whether you're using Corel Painter or ParticleShop, you might have 15 brushes, or if you're using Corel Painter Essentials, you'll only have 10. I've gone ahead and put all these brushes in a custom palette, and the ones that are available only in Essentials have an E next to them. So let's go ahead and start with Blacklight. I've created some layers here in my layers palette to paint onto, and Blacklight tends to work best if you use kind of a blacklight color, so somewhere in this kind of purple-violet range. And then because these are all glow brushes, you're also going to want to choose a color that's a bit darker than the final result that you think you're going to get. So let's go ahead and choose something like that really dark purple, and let's paint a stroke. Now you can see that we get something that starts out kind of violet, but if we begin to paint over it, then it starts to kind of turn purplish or pinkish, which gives us a really nice blacklight effect. So we could use this to write with. Now depending on whether your brush is big, medium, or small, you're going to get different results. So if I use a really small brush, it's going to look a lot different, and as I start to get bigger with my brush, and it'll really start to change how it looks. And because this is a particle brush, you don't necessarily want to trust this visual indicator when you're painting, because the diameter of the brush is going to be a lot smaller than that. Now, as I start to paint over in this pink area, you might notice that it has this darkness along the edges, and that doesn't look very much like light. So what we'll want to do for all of these brushes, if we're going to blend them with a background, is we'll want to set the composite method, or the blend mode, to screen. And that's going to make it blend with the background colors as if it were a light. We can move on to the next one, which is Ether. Ether is going to give us these little multicolored squiggles. So we want to choose a darker color. It doesn't really matter which hue you choose because it's going to change the hue each time you paint. So you just tap to put in these little squiggles. If you press really hard, it'll start to build up. And if you tap lightly, then you'll get a really quick, smaller one or a more spontaneous, thinner one. If you make your brush bigger, then you'll get these bigger shapes. If you make your brush smaller, then you'll get finer little squiggles. Let's move on to the next brush, which is Fairies. Fairies have color variability as well, so if we tap, you can see that it changes colors each time we tap, and it creates these interesting random little shapes. If you use a quick tap, they're smaller. If you use a firm, long tap, then they build up and they're very broad. And of course, you can make your brush small for smaller shapes, or make your brush really big for bigger shapes. Next is Hyper Speed. I'm going to go ahead and choose kind of a blue-greenish color like this. And hyperspeed works best if you do really quick strokes like this. So you could do little lines that shoot out of something. If you make your brush bigger, then you get a thicker, wider line. And if you make it smaller, then you get a thinner line. But you can get some really interesting light effects here with this. Now again, we want to set this to a screen composite method, and it'll blend much more naturally with the background. The next brush we'll look at is called Laser Show. I'm going to select kind of a greenish color this time. Again, I'm keeping it very dark. And with this brush, you want to select the diameter of the effect you're going to get. This is going to be kind of a spinning laser. What you want to do is you want to tap and you want to start spinning your brush and then just hold in the middle. I'm still holding, not moving my pen, and it's creating that nice laser show effect. This one takes a bit of practice because the brush moves on its own, but what you want to do is just tap down and then start spinning. And if you pull your brush kind of outwards while you start that spin, that'll kind of determine how far those lasers go. And I'm just holding in the middle to let it build up. The next brush we'll look at is called LED. Now with LEDs, you size your brush about the size of the LED that you want, and then you just tap and hold. If you tap quickly, you'll get a thin light. If you tap and hold for a long time, it'll build up to a thicker light. And of course, I can make smaller lights if I make my brush much smaller, or bigger lights if I make my brush much bigger. If I want to change the color of the LEDs, I can just choose a different color, and I can have any colored light that I want. And because these are particle brushes, some of these will determine their own angle, and if that's not the angle that you want the light to go, what you can do is just create a new layer, make sure it's set to screen, and then go ahead and just paint in your LED the way you want it, and then you can go to Edit, Free Transform, we'll go to Rotate, and then I can just rotate it where I want it to be, and go to Move, and then I can move it where I want it to go, and I could even scale it up or down if I wanted to. So that gives me a lot more control over each brush stroke. The next brush is called Light Tube. If I tap and hold, then I create this light tube. This could be something like a fluorescent tube. So if you wanted to make something like a track of lights, you could do that. And if you tap quickly, you get a thinner light. If you tap and hold, it'll build up. You can also paint with this as if it's a brush, and it creates some really cool effects. If you use lighter pressure, you'll get kind of a thinner line. And if you use heavier pressure, you'll get a big thick line. It has this nice jagged edge. So if you scrub kind of back and forth like this, you can get some interesting maybe wind or water effects with this too. And of course, I could change my color to a different color. It's a very cool brush. Next is a brush called Light Speed. I'm going to choose kind of an aqua color for this one. And we'll do kind of zigzag strokes, and we get this really cool light speed effect. We can do little trails that come off of it like this. So if you wanted to do like an outer space drawing with a ship flying through space, stars whizzing by, you could do something like that. Now if you do short little taps and kind of lift your pen up, you can get something like this as well. Or you can paint strokes with it like so. It's a very versatile brush. And then if you want these light streaks to be going the opposite direction, then all you need to do is go to Edit, Flip Horizontal, and that'll flip that layer. I will also mention that if you're using Corel Painter, you can go to your Advanced Brush Controls. And this will allow us to do a lot more with these brushes because we can tweak some of these settings to get different effects. So for example, in Particles Common, we can change the direction of the force, and then we can have this brush go in a different direction if you wanted like a meteor shower or something like that. We can look in the color variability, and if we want more color variability, we can do that. Or if we want less, then we can do that. So it's a more uniform color. We can increase and decrease the count as well. If we make it very low, this will give us more of an aurora borealis kind of effect. So it's worth going in here and experimenting with these different settings to see the different results you can get. If you want to know what a property does, just hover over it and you'll get a little tooltip. If you're using ParticleShop, you will have a few controls available to you as well to change how these brushes can perform. The next brush is called Neon Chalk. I'm going to choose kind of a pinkish color, and we can tap and hold to create these little blobs of neon light. If we tap and hold, it builds up. If we tap quickly, then it's just a quick little dot like a star. If we make our brush bigger, then we get a bigger light. We can also write with this brush. Now you want to write fairly slowly so that it has time to build up, and we could spell out neon. Now if you're using Corel Painter, you can also change the paper texture with this particular brush if you want to change that chalk texture. I'm going to change this from basic paper to small dots, and now you can see that the texture we get is much different. So feel free to experiment with these papers to see the kind of effects you can get with this brush. The next brush that we'll look at is called Phosphor. I'm going to choose kind of a cyan blue like this. I'm going to make sure to change my paper back to the default basic paper. Do a little test stroke here, and you can see I get this really cool kind of blue fire effect. So I can do some really interesting things with this brush. If I tap and hold, it'll build up, and then I can just kind of pull off of it little wisps like this. Or I can do quick little taps if I want to create these little wisps that are floating in the air. If you're using Corel Painter and you don't like this grainy effect, you can turn the grain down to zero. Then you'll get something a bit smoother like this. The next brush we'll look at is called Spinner. I'm going to choose kind of a pinkish color like this. Spinner is kind of similar to Laser Show in that the particles will dance around depending on how you move your brush. So I'm going to kind of draw a really quick Z shape, and then I'm going to hold my brush still and just let it build up. Now I'll draw a really quick N shape, and I'll hold my brush and let it build up. Now I'll spin kind of a spinny shape like that, and then tap in the center and hold, and we'll let it build up, and we'll get something like that. So you can see, depending on the different kinds of gestures that you do, you can get a lot of versatility out of this brush. You could also just draw with it like this if you wanted to, or wiggle it back and forth, and then move the brush, and just let it move as you're traveling with the brush. Really interesting what you can do with this. Let's take a look at Spotlight. I'm going to choose kind of a pinkish reddish color like this, and I'll just tap and hold, and we'll let our light build up. And if we make our brush bigger, we'll get a bigger spotlight. If we make our brush smaller, we'll get a smaller spotlight. Now you'll notice that it's just going straight up. So what you can do is create a new layer for that. Make sure it's set to screen. Paint in your spotlight, but make sure that it's not going off the canvas so that it gets cut off. And then go to Edit, Free Transform, and then you can rotate it, and you can move it into position. Next, we'll look at Static. I'm going to choose kind of a purplish color like this. And let's paint a test stroke. We'll go really slow here because then it gives it time to build up. And you get this really cool static electricity effect. Now you could make lightning bolts or little cracks and things like that. Or you could do handwriting with it if you wanted to. It's a really interesting brush. You can also tap and hold to create these little wisps. If you make your brush smaller, then you can get these finer little cracks like this as well. Next is Tracer. I'm going to choose a yellowish color like this. We'll do a test stroke, and you can see that Tracer is kind of slowed down so that you can very easily control it, but it still wiggles around a bit to give your line some character. So you can build this up and create these really interesting tracer effects. And you could go over it again if you wanted to and kind of build it up. You can also tap with it if you wanted to create little stars or very distant lights. And last but not least, we'll take a look at Vapor Lamp. I'm going to choose kind of an aqua color like this. And if we tap and hold, we can build up these nice foggy looking lights. We can also draw with it like this. You can also hold shift if you wanted to constrain this and make it into kind of like a long light bulb or something. And again, if you're using the full version of Corel Painter, then you can reduce the amount of grain if you don't like the grain. That gives you a different kind of result. Or if you do like the grain but you want it to look different, then you can change your paper to something else, let's say pebble board, and that'll give you a different kind of texture. So there you go, that's a demonstration of how to use Corel's Neon Lights brush pack. If you enjoyed this video, take a quick second to click the like button, and make sure to subscribe for more Corel tutorials like this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.